صلى الله عليك يا سيدي ويا مولاي يا رسول الله، صلى الله عليك يا سيدي ومولاي وابن مولاي يا أبا عبد الله. السلام عليك يا مولاي يا أبا عبد الله وعلى الأرواح التي حلت بفنائك، عليك مني سلام الله أبدا ما بقيت وبقي الليل والنهار، ما خاب من تمسك بكم سادتي، أمن من لجأ إليكم، يا ليتنا كنا معكم فنفوز فوزا عظيما. يا غريب يا مظلوم كربلاء، يوم القرر المظلوم سفيرا يرسل السفرا، يا مسلم جمع أولاده وصاهم على النصرة، جمع عائلة المغيوب وعلى حسين وصاهم، خمس أولاد حشمهم حميدة وعاتقة وياهم، بيض وجهي يا أولادي وهمل دمعة على فرقاهم، قالهم يا سواد العين وعد منا نفد الدين، بعدك ما نعوف حسين ونفدي الروح، يا أبويا فدا لمدلل الزهرة. شو يقول مسلم؟ أنا موعود من عمي علي الكرار يذبحوني، يجيكم خبر بعد أيام من القصر للقاع يذبوني، يفصلوا راسي عن جسمي وبالأسواق يسحبوني، وراسي على الثرى مترب وقطرة ماي ما أشرب، ولا حد يمي يتقرب، وعدد لي مصايبكم وخلي الروح وحمد فطرة. يا the day the messenger was to leave his loved ones behind, Muslim gathered his children and said, I entrust you with this will of mine. I entrust you with your uncle Hussein's allegiance and loyalty. Five boys, Hamida and Atika, accepted the obedience of royalty. He said, make me proud in the eyes of Fatima al-Zahra and Ali, and said his farewells with tears flowing for what will soon be. They promised to serve their Imam with their entire existence. Muslim cried and foretold them of what will happen to him in the distance, saying, my uncle Ali promised I will be greeted by Kufans with slaughter. You will receive grave news. They threw my body from tower tops, thirsty with no water. Dragged my body through the Kufan streets. In this state, the Lord I will meet. But no one will come forward before this fate to inform me of my darling children's tragic state, of my daughters running from burning tents into chains. After they kill my beloved master Hussein, or of my sons who were killed mercilessly for no crime. This is the tragedy of every child of mine. After the people of Kufa sent many letters to Imam Hussein Salamullahi Alayhi saying, we invite you to come to Kufa as we have no Imam to guide us. Through you, Allah, will unite us on the path of truth. Imam Hussein wrote a letter back, I am sending my brother, my cousin Muslim ibn Aqil, who is my family's most trusted representative. I have instructed him to write to me about your situation, circumstances, and opinions. When Muslim arrived to Kufa, more than 18,000 people appeared before him and pledged allegiance to Imam Hussein. Muslim was encouraged by the overwhelming response that he sent a letter to Abu Abdullah to proceed to Kufa. Bashir ibn Nu'man was the governor of Kufa and did not interfere or harm Muslim as he had respect for Ahlul Bayt's family members. This was seen as a sign of weakness to the supporters of Yazid, and by recommendation of Sir John, Muawiyah's advisor, Yazid sent Ibn Ziyad, disguised as Imam Hussein. He entered Kufa while covered, and people cheered as he arrived. Once he settled in the castle, he gave a sermon warning the people of Kufa of the punishment of crucifixion for anyone aiding or sheltering those who scheme against Yazid. The fear slowly crept in the hearts of the Kufans, and those 18,000 supporters became less and less. Muslim was joined in congregational prayers with a great number. By the time he was done his taslim, looking over his shoulder, there was but a mere 4 supporters. He whispered, Ya Ashbah al-Rijal, wa lastum birijal. O you who resemble men, but are far from it. The strict orders of the Kufan police led Muslim to Hani ibn Urwa's house. He hid there until a spy by the name of Ma'qal tricked Hani and got him arrested and tortured for aiding Muslim. Ubaydullah ibn Ziyad, la'anahullah, ordered his men to sever Hani's head, and they threw his body down a well. Muslim realized here the seriousness of the situation and that Imam Hussein would come to a trap set up for him in Kufa. He tried to escape to warn Imam Hussein, but the gates of Kufa were closed and spies were sent to trace Muslim. Imagine now, Muslim alone. Walking in the dark streets of Kufa, hungry and thirsty, with no one to aid him. Imagine the feeling of being in an unfamiliar place, wandering in the darkness as treachery and death followed you. His tired feet carried him until he reached the house of a lady by the name of Tawa. He asked her, Amat Allah, can I have a drink of water? She quenched his thirst and closed her doors. Later, she came out to find him still sitting at her doorstep. وكأني بها تقول تقل له واقف على بابي ودمع العين سايل واقف على بابي ودمع العين سايل جنك من السؤال لو عندك رسايل شوفتك والله من الذي كانوا وسايل جنك غريب بالمدينة وما لك أصحاب قال هاي غريب وغربتي دون الغرايب جم من غريب تغرب وحصل حبايب بس أنا بهالديرة بقيت بلا قرايب والبايعوني داسوا البيعة بنتراب قالها وعين مستديرة أنا لا أخال عندي ولا عشيرة أنا مسلم أنا مسلم الفاقد نصيرة أنا الحيرتي ما جرت حيرة أنا الحيرتي ما جرت حيرة شي عاصم واري يستنى ما يدور Are you a beggar or are you one who has news or a letter? You seem like a stranger to these lands with no companions. Did you stray from your path or were you abandoned? He tells her, I'm a stranger like any other to these lands. How many other strangers come along and find a helping hand? I have no family, no companions, and the people broke allegiance they gave. He says with his white teary eyes, I'm surrounded by cowards and far from the brave. The people left the truthful for a worldly bribe. I am Muslim, I am Muslim. Alone with no family or my tribe. She says, where are you from? Where is your family and kin? Your state is hard on me. I do not know you. I can't let you in. You look lost and far from your home so far. Tell me, oh stranger, who you are. He says, وقفتي صعبة على الباب لا معوز اجيت ولا طلاب بني هاشم عمامي وفخر الانساب وعم المرتضى حامل حمية It's hard for me to stand at your door. I did not come needy, nor am I poor. Banu Hashim are my uncles, as honorable as can be. And my uncle is the greatest warrior of Islam, Ali. She was in shock and began to cry and slap her face in shame, saying, A'adhirni Muslim, A'adhirni ya Muslim. طال انتظارك اتفضل سيدي والدار دارك تصيح مسلم ضيفنا اليوم يا يوم مبارك اعذرني سيدي خاف اندهنتك صدقني يا مسلم ما عرفتك لو انا ادري مين اهلك ما نشدتك شلون اعتذر انا من الزكية شلون اعتذر انا من الزكية Forgive me Muslim for I made you wait long Take this as your home where you belong. Muslim is our guest. This day is surely blessed. Forgive me, master. I did not know your name to be addressed. If I knew who you were, I would have quickly let you in. How will I face Muhammad Ali and Fatima with this grave sin? She lets him in, puts him food and water, but he only drinks a little and spends the night in worship. Her son notices her entering the guest room repeatedly and asks her about this. She tells him to keep it a secret and she says she has sheltered Muslim. He replies saying, you have done a great deed, dear mother. But he soon betrayed his guest and told Ibn Ziyad of Muslim's location in return for gold and position. The morning comes and Tawa walks in and finds Muslim in worship. She asks, have you slept at all, my son? He said, I slept for a short while and I saw my uncle Amirul Mu'mineen Ali telling me, Al-Ajal, 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 hasten your arrival, Muslim. She asked, what is the meaning? He replied, I will be killed this day. Soon as he finished his sentence, they hear Ibn Ziyad's army outside. Look at this woman. Tawa ran and brought his sword and armor, said, O Muslim, remind them of the battles of your uncle Amirul Mu'mineen. He says, Ya ta'at shaj'ini, Ya ta'at shaj'ini, Ub'ammi haydar tidhakrini, والله لرد جمع يجيني ما دام صمصام بيميني. Tawa, you encourage me and remind me of my uncle Ali. I will send them on their way as long as my sword remains with me. He calls out, أقسمتُ أن لا أقتل إلا حرا وإن وجدت الموت شيئا نكرا. I swore I will die a free man and I do not fear death. He attacked ferociously, breaking the door and using it as a shield, calling out, Ya Allah, Ya Muhammad, Ya Ali, fighting like a true Hashimi. This is the nephew of Amirul Mu'mineen. They surrounded him and covered the rooftops. They could not restrain him. Some dug traps and others began to throw stones, burning logs and arrows, until he was covered in wounds. Then a man named Bakir ibn Umran promised him safe passage. Muslim replied, you people cannot keep your word, you are betrayers. Bakir struck Muslim while he rested till his mouth bled severely. But Muslim fought back until he fell into one of their traps. They dug, they captured him and took him to Ibn Ziyad. When he is brought before Ibn Ziyad walks in. Muslim refuses to say his salams. Shamir la'anahullah tells him, say salam to your master. He replies, my master, my only master is Hussein. Muslim asks for water. They bring the first bowl. It fills with blood from his mouth. Then the second and third. His teeth fall into it and he says, by Allah, it surely is not for me. Ibn Ziyad orders Ibn al-Ash'ath to take Muslim to the top of the tower, behead him and throw his body from the top. They take him. He then requests a prayer to rak'at. Doing so, then he turns towards where Imam Hussein is and cries out. The guard laughs and says, such a man who performs a revolution does not cry. Muslim replies, La wallah, ma ala hali bakit, walakin bukai ala al-Husayn. بكائي على سيدي ومولاي أبا عبد الله. By Allah, I do not cry for myself, I cry for Hussein. My tears are for my master Abu Abdullah. As if I can imagine him calling out, Hussein, lo minni wassallit al-khabar. بالسفر يا حسين عيد النظر ولا تجيب وياك زينب بالسفر خاف بالكوفة يمر بها القهر ترش بنار شي ترمي بحجار وتنظر اخوها راس فوق رمح استقر ما stay if I could speak to you now I'd tell you to turn back the ambush awaits you they've set their trap do not bring Zainab the women and children here what they might encounter in this place I truly question and fear captives meet rocks and flames as a welcome while the people cheer and I cannot fathom what Zainab feels watching your head parading on a spear Ajarakum Allah he said in salam Abu Abdullah. They struck his neck with a blade. They threw his body from the tower, crushing his bones. They tied his body and harnessed body to horses and dragged them through the streets of Kufa. Rahim Allahu man nada wa muslima. ومظلومه وغانئه ومظلومه Two messengers left Kufa in a hurry and delivered the news to Imam Hussein. The Imam broke down and cried uncontrollably and asked the women to bring Hamida, daughter of Muslim. He held her close in his lap. He began to stroke her head. She said, Oh uncle, you are But why do you stroke my head like that of an orphan? تقول يا عمي يا عمي بويا وينه من زمان ما بين علينا أخبار منا ما تجينا تجينا يمكن أبويا قاتلنا Uncle, uncle, where is my father? It's been long since he's crossed my side. What, we haven't heard from him. Have they killed him or am I right? Hamida, my darling, Imam Hussein says, Hamida, my darling, I am now your father. She says, Uncle, but I have a father. Muslim is my father. Uncle, why do you wipe my head like that of orphans? Did anything happen to my father? Uncle, oh, uncle, where is my father? She says, why do you do these movements? Imam Hussein tells her, your father has been martyred and you are now an orphan. She cries out, Wa abata wa muslima. وكأني بها تقول أوقاف يضع عن بديار الأحباب أشم ريحة أبويا الفارقاني ودوني على قبره خلني حاجيه وقل الدمع من عقبك عماني شوف الحبل بويا سوى بالإيد صغيرة على اليسار والهم لواني من يوم رحيت ومفارق النوم، كون وياك بالكوفة وعساني بويا بويا من غمض عيونك وقت الوداع، بيا وبيش ما يرحم زماني اقعد بويا جيت وجبت الماي وياي انت لترتوي يا الارواني، عسب القصر بويا انخسفت القاع يا الرماك من القصر ردوا رماني، هم مثلي اشوف بيدك حبال عدوك لا رعاك ولا رعاني، صدق يا الغالي بالشارع يجروك مثل ما بالحبل ذاك السباني. I stand here in the home of my loved ones. I smell father's essence linger in the air. Hamida says, those who lost someone dear know how deep the pain runs. A feeling that can't be compared. Take me to his resting place so I can tell him of my ordeal. Complain to what's left of his body and face and say I refuse to sleep and meals. Show my father the marks from ropes and chains. I'm too young for this pain and sorrow. Trials poured on us captives like rain, wishing without you we don't see tomorrow. Father who struck your holy neck, who threw you from the tower top, the ones who killed you left my soul in a wreck. They tied and whipped me and would not stop. I bought you water, here drink so I can too. I know you stayed thirsty. Get up, Father, I've come to you. These evil men had no mercy. I notice you have marks on your wrists, just like mine, Father. Look and see, they dragged your body in Kufa's midst, just like Tisham they dragged me. Inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un wa sayalamu alladhina zalamu ayya munqalabin yanqalibun wal aqibatu lil muttaqin. يا كاشف السوء اكشف السوء عنا يا الله. اللهم شاف مرضانا وفك أسرانا وانصر مجاهدينا ولأرواح علمائنا وأمواتنا. رحم الله من قرأ السورة المباركة الفاتحة مع الصلوات.